So what makes a good tokenomics model? Well, it's not so easy to answer this question right now because all the research in tokenomics is so new. However, I'd say that there are three main things that need to be taken care of. The first one is the parameters of the ICO. So it seems that for many of those parameters, the details are not so crucial. For example, the number of tokens is not probably such an important parameter as many people think. However, other ones, such as the stages of the ICO, is important, or things such as the actual amounts raised. But this does not relate only to tokenomics. This mainly relates to the business itself, right? So this is also a business problem. The second factor, which is very important and relates to tokenomics 100%, is the protection against incidents. You know, so for example, wild speculation, it can bring down a business to its knees. So this could make an economy crash. And this goes hand in hand with volatility or the inflation. So in the real world, we have central banks to deal with some of those problems. So how do we deal with those problems in a closed economy, okay, in this virtual economy of blockchain startup? And finally, the right incentive structure. That's also a very important question for a tokenomics model, whether the structure, the incentives provided to the users are the right ones. Okay, and this relates both to the tokenomics and to the business itself. A good model would create value for the user through the business proposition. However, at the same time, it would make sure that the token appreciates in value at a steady rate. There's not much volatility, and the users can feel happy with the product or their service they're getting. But at the same time, the investors that invested early on in the token, they can make sure that they're actually getting their investment back. So in summary, tokenomics is new as a discipline. There are many questions around tokenomics which are not currently answered. However, this does not mean that we shouldn't try to answer them, because there's active research going on in tokenomics right now. And essentially, many of the startups that are launching with new tokenomics models, these are like active experiments. And I do believe that tokenomics can be seen as economics version 2.0, because it's easier to collect data in a blockchain in contrast to the real world, and it's easier to manipulate the economy in a benevolent way, obviously, in order to control things such as the volatility of the price. And also, in a sense, the closed economies created by blockchain startups, I would dare to say they're less critical. You know, so in the real world, let's say if the central bank misses something, maybe this could lead to financial crash or whatever. However, a startup has more room to maneuver because what they're doing does not suffer from so many externalities. And tokenomics is a green field, which means there are no standards. And most important, we don't have data of ICO startups that have been running for 10 years successfully, because this everything is so new. However, tools such as agent-based modeling, I believe they can help mitigate the risk, because even if we don't have the right theories or the right models right now, agent-based models are very flexible, and they can allow us to incorporate many of our assumptions explicitly and then study them. Okay, so it's a tool that I particularly believe in, and it would also be good to, you know, hear about your opinion in the comments. So this was Stelios from the TESSERACT Academy. I hope you enjoyed this short video about tokenomics, and I hope to see you soon in another one of our videos. Thank you.